bird and the bees. When I hit 13, the noun between my legs turning into a verb. My father sat me down and said, "Son, one day you will have a wife of your own. A man will come, a helpful neighbor knocking while you're at work, perhaps, or a garlicky colleague at an office party, or a lifeguard on a spit of sand. And that man will grip your beloved, perhaps even in your sheets. But that won't mean you're weak. Remember our great ancestor, Menelaus. Triceps the size of grapefruits. His chest far hairier than that slim-hipped boy who slipped in and swiped his wife like a calla lily from his lapel. Remember Marcus Aurelius's words. Reject your sense of injury, and the injury itself disappears. No need to launch another Trojan just because some stallion trotted into her. No need to perish like Pushkin, slumped in ice. Begin preparing now. When friends sleep over, let them colonize your bed. Never yell shotgun. The back seat will scrub you down, so years later, when your wife stumbles home with that glazed, seen God look in her eyes, the sweat of his trigger-happy fingers still greasing the white napkin of her thighs, you can settle into that moment. Ask her how it was, if you can witness next time. I am not an idiot. I know what happened at the bar. Me and your pal Jake from college, on stools, sipping tall boys. You smiling between us, the dutiful wife, rubbing the notches in my spine. I know he was scribbling cave paintings onto your thigh. Tingles crackling under your skirt, shorter than summer in Alaska. I know later at home you poured 3 thick fingers of cognac, so he was too boozed to drive, had to crash on the pullout. I know you hurried me into the jacuzzi of your mouth just to drowsy me. That after I exploded, you patted down with my bouquet on your breath and held open your butterfly wings. I know his crushed pearls were drying on your skin, and you tiptoed in with dawn, the reverb of his olive fingers still sprinting through your hair. The Furies. O kindly ones, with eyes soft as panda fur, and hair that supplies its own rough breeze, would you like a nibble of this tart, baked with scraps of stray dog heart? There's a fracture in my chimney, a crack rippling through my wedding ring. Twice a week my wife brings back the soil from another man's flower bed. I wonder if you might speak with him in your language of fire, one he seems to both play with and comprehend.